What's up? As you already know from the title, today I'm going to share how to identify fonts fast in any circumstances. I'm working with Netflix for almost 2.5 years now, designing titles for TV series and films. The most common problem is that most of the time they will send files that they are flat, meaning that I need first to identify the font before moving to the designing part. If you're interested to see more of my work with Netflix, you can do it in my Behance page. Link in the description. In the beginning, I was doing this. And if you own a lot of fonts, you know how time consuming this is. So I'm going to show you my four basic methods for web, digital, and print fonts. For websites, I'm using extensions for Chrome and add-ons for Firefox. My favorite one is Font Face Ninja. Unfortunately, this one is only on Chrome, but you can definitely find similar ones for other browsers. Install it and then click on the icon on the right. It will reveal all the fonts on the website, but you can also hover over the text. And what I like about this one is that it gives you a lot more information about it, like size and color. And I have used this method recently for a company that owns a lot of sub companies, and I wanted to create websites for each one of them based on the main website. I mostly use the next two methods where I'm working on titles for Netflix, and you can use them when you have a picture, JPEG or PNG for example. The first one is called WhatTheFont from myfonts.com. Upload the picture and you will have a variety of fonts to select. The downside with this method is that first, it doesn't take a lot of time, but there is a process involved to open up the website, upload the picture, edit the picture if it doesn't recognize it. And second, most of the choices available will be fonts that you will need to buy. And you should definitely buy fonts, especially if it's for a paid project. But why not use the fonts that you already own? And here's where the second method comes into play. I was so happy when Adobe made that update. Ready? Open up Photoshop, grab the marquee tool, go to type, match font, and you're done. Easy, fast, and most importantly, those are the fonts that you have already installed in your computer. Or Photoshop suggests fonts available to sync from Typekit. This means that if you are paying for Adobe, you also have unlimited fonts to choose from the Adobe fonts for free. You're probably asking yourself why I have included the first method then. This is because Adobe provides you with thousands of fonts, but not all of them. In the other hand, WhatTheFont could sometimes be more accurate on what the real font is. For the final method, imagine that you're walking down the street and you see that awesome handbag or billboard or whatever, and again you're wondering what font did they use. Just grab your phone, take a picture or scan it, and you can use the WhatTheFont app with the same methodology. Those are my favorite techniques to use, and I will have links in the description for all of them. I hope that you have found this video helpful, and before I go, quick test. Let me know in the comments, which font is this one?